my experience of politics obviously was not a happy one. And I did not want my husband to join politics because I felt that, my brother-in-law had been killed, mother-in-law had been assassinated. And there were a number of threats on us, on him. I didn't want him to join because I felt that I would lose him.
From shy Gandhi Bahu to one of India's most powerful politicians, here's the story of Sonia Gandhi through a series of rare interviews. Sonia Minor was born into a middle-class family in a small town in Italy in 1946. When she was 18, she moved to England for her studies, where she met Rajiv Gandhi, the eldest son of the then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, and the two fell in love.
They could never separate them. Nothing can separate them. She walked in and I was always very busy at the lunchtime. And I had no place for her to sit. And Rajiv was sitting on the round table waiting for his friends. So I said, do you mind if I put a young lady on your table? And that is Rajiv, Sonia, nothing more. You wouldn't believe it. They fall in love there and then.
Sonia moved to India and they were married in 1968. Sonia wearing the sari that Jawaharlal Nehru spun in jail.
This is somebody who, at that point, not only loathed politics and politicians, etc., but swore that you'd rather her children begged in the streets than went into politics.
All that changed when the then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi was assassinated in 1984. Sonia's husband Rajiv won the subsequent elections, and suddenly, Sonia became India's first lady.
When my husband was Prime Minister, or even earlier on, when there was a lot of focus on us, and we had very little space to ourselves only. I think perhaps at that time I became even more not obsessed, but even more careful about keeping, maintaining some sort of privacy for our family. But basically, I am a rather private person.
She began to model herself after Indira, emulating the way she would drape her sari, and what others later realized absorbed the art of politics as well. When Rajiv was assassinated in 1991, the Congress looked to a grieving Sonia Gandhi to take over the reins of the party. She refused and instead got involved in setting up the Rajiv Gandhi Foundation. The party would look to her again 7 years later, when the Congress suffered a humiliating defeat in the 1998 Lok Sabha elections. This time, she agreed.
When she began, she absolutely wanted nothing to do with politics. It was a huge effort for her. She's an extremely shy person.
Party mein nayapan lakar hi hum apne raste mein aane wale sankaton aur rukavaton ka tezi se mukabla kar sakte.
For her to make speeches in front of lakhs and lakhs of people, make them in Hindi, know that everybody is watching, that was a big effort. And I think she has just, I mean, I'm her daughter, so perhaps it sounds silly coming from me, but I really admire her evolution.
People expected her to be a puppet in the hands of powerful Congress leaders. But Sonia surprised everyone by having an iron grip on the party and steering it through the ups and downs of a coalition government. In 1999, she attended the famous Tea Party with Jayalalitha, following which the AIADMK leader withdrew support to the Vajpayee government and the NDA coalition came crashing down. That year, Sonia fought her first elections, contesting from both Amethi in Uttar Pradesh and Bellari in Karnataka. The BJP fielded heavyweight Sushma Swaraj against her in Bellari, but Sonia managed to win both seats, sparking a lifelong rivalry with Sushma. Then came a fatal mistake. She made this triumphant announcement in front of the Rashtrapati Bhavan.
I don't know how many numbers they claim to have. They say, I believe they have 270. Well, we have 272 and we hope to get more.
Sonia was banking on the support of allies like Jayalalitha and Mulayam, who in a surprise move publicly declared that they would not back a foreign origin leader. The Congress's claim crumbled and Sonia's credibility plummeted.
Do you regret the decision you took in 1999 when you did not give support to Sonia Gandhi and therefore facilitated 5 more years of BJP rule? Do you regret that?
I'm not very happy about it. And I don't have any embarrassment in saying that I do regret it.
Was it a mistake?
Of course it was. And this was not a mistake from one side, it was a mistake from two sides. It was a mistake of Congress as well, because they were not in a mood to accept coalition dharma at that point of time.
After that public debacle, she worked to reorient her political instincts. She surrounded herself with loyalists and threw herself into understanding the vagaries of Indian politics. In the run-up to the 2004 elections, she worked to stitch together the UPA alliance, even allying with the DMK, who were at the time lobbying against the death sentence to Rajiv Gandhi's killers. With her political strategy in place, the once-shy Sonia went all guns blazing in her attack against the BJP.
Can Advani ji today take any step, take any action without first going and touching the feet of the RSS leaders?
With Sonia leading from the front, the UPA had a resounding victory in 2004. But the idea of an Italian woman as a prospective prime minister drew wildly opposite reactions.
Shrimati Sonia Gandhi ko pradhanmantri pad ki shapath dilai jati hai to udhar unki shapath hogi aur idhar mera tyag patra hoga aur ye ladai main ek bhikshuni ke taur par ladungi jisme main rangin vastra utar kar keval shwet vastra dharan karungi safed saadi dharan karungi apne kesh kata dungi.
Please remain with us, we need your leadership. It is only under the prime ministership of Prime Minister Sonia Gandhi that this party will remain united.
But Sonia stood her ground and pulled off one of the greatest political surprises.
Post of Prime Minister has not been my aim. I was always certain that if ever I found myself in the position that I am in today, I would follow my inner voice. Today, that voice tells me I must humbly decline this post.
Universal presumption was that if the Congress is able to get a majority, it will be Sonia who will be the leader. Till today, what transpired between the President and Sonia ji is a mystery for me, all of us. But suddenly, after she came back, there was a total change. And then Manmohan Singh became the Prime Minister.
The move in an instant transformed the nation's perception of Sonia. She went from being a power-hungry foreigner to a selfless leader who was willing to sacrifice power for national interest.
You, 18 months ago, decided not to become the Prime Minister of the country. I think the country was taken aback and you said you were responding to your inner voice.
Yes. That voice is very much the same.
It's still there?
Yes. It has not, there's no change.
No regrets?
Not at all.
No regrets that you gave up the biggest prize of all?
Not at all.
During her time in power, Sonia pushed forward people first measures like the RTI Act, NREGA and the Women's Reservation Bill.
Dr. Singh once told me in a private conversation, he rated his own performance as 6 on 10. How would you rate him? He's a man who doesn't like to trumpet his achievements. How would you rate him?
In fact, I would say he does the opposite. He is very reticent to talk about the good work that he's been done, that he has done and he's been doing.
How many marks would you give him?
I don't like to give marks, but I think
you're fully satisfied?
Done a very good job under the circumstances. He became Prime Minister unexpectedly and I have absolutely no complaint.
She backed Manmohan Singh's stand favouring the Indo-US nuclear deal, even managing to convince her one-time rival Mulayam Singh to vote in its favour. During the 2007 Gujarat election campaign, Sonia launched into a diatribe against then Chief Minister Narendra Modi. It was a terrible political miscalculation, which backfired to help Modi win a second term in office. But it didn't affect the Congress on the national level. The Sonia Manmohan combine went on to win the re-elections in 2009.
She has been a guardian angel for our UPA government correcting us when we went astray or when there was weakening of resolve. We need her guidance for the next 5 years.
The credibility of the UPA government was damaged as one scam after another came tumbling out. Subramanian Swamy in particular has been one of Sonia's harshest critics, pursuing several legal cases against her.
When I'll go to court, I'm not going to give you
a timetable. You just hinted that this is not imminent.
I didn't hint it at all. That is your surmise. You are a great one at
making
surmises.
Will your decision to go to court be at all affected by the fact that Sonia Gandhi is abroad? She's going through surgery. She could be fairly seriously ill.
Certainly, it will not be as enjoyable if she's not in hospital.
He accused Sonia and Rahul in the National Herald scam, which forced them to make their first appearance in court.
Mere fact is that she had only a 5 lakh rupee authorized capital company, and by a fraud, she has come to acquire more than 2,000 crores worth of property. How is that possible without cheating?
The Congress faced a devastating defeat in the 2014 elections. They were reduced to their lowest tally in history, and Sonia took the fall. Even when not in power, the party continued to battle corruption allegations.
A plea was made to somebody in high place in Italy to make the Prime Minister of Italy contact our Prime Minister, of whom I have great regard. I know that personally he will do nothing wrong, but he takes orders very easily. That's his major minus point.
All what they are saying, all the accusations they are throwing at us, they are false. They amount to calumny. I'm saying this government is there for the last 2 years. What are they doing? The inquiry is there. Why don't they complete it?
रोज कुछ न कुछ ये लोग बहाना बनाते हैं, गलत इल्जाम लगाते हैं। अगर कुछ ऐसी बात है, तो बिना भेदभाव जांच करो। दूध का दूध, पानी का पानी।
Meanwhile, within the party, there emerged a clash of ideologies. On one side was Rahul, who wanted more young Turks to be in organizational roles. On the other, senior Congress leaders who wanted the old guard to lead the charge. In 2017, Sonia stepped aside and Rahul was formally named the president of the Congress party.
बचपन से ही उसने हिंसा का अपार दुख झेला था, लेकिन राजनीति में आने पर उसने एक ऐसे भयंकर व्यक्तिगत हमले का सामना किया जिसने उसको और भी निडर और मजबूत दिल का इंसान बनाया है।
Over the next 2 years, Sonia kept a low profile, traveling abroad frequently for medical treatment. She continued to advise Rahul from the sidelines and fend off attacks from Narendra Modi.
अहंकार देखिए, मैं इस सदन को याद कराना चाहता हूँ 1999 राष्ट्रपति भवन के सामने खड़े होकर के दावा किया गया था हमारे पास तो 272 की संख्या है और हमारे साथ और भी जुड़ने वाले हैं 272
आप समझ गए हैं कि 2014 के सबका साथ सबका विकास मैं ना खाऊंगा ना खाने दूंगा जैसे उनके वादे सिर्फ और सिर्फ ड्रामेबाजी.
Despite the Congress's decline across the country, Sonia proved that her political charisma still holds sway. In the 2019 Lok Sabha elections, she managed to retain her Raebareli seat, but Rahul lost the family bastion of Amethi. That loss led to Rahul stepping down as president, leading to a power vacuum.
There has been a lot of internal power struggle, and the Congress party at present is like, you know, different, you know, individuals who themselves acting as Congress party rather than, a unified front.
Sonia reprised her role as top party chief. She has been actively involved in overseeing the Maharashtra, Haryana and Jharkhand elections, where the Congress managed to regain lost ground. With no other acceptable leadership in sight, it looks like Sonia will continue to lead the party.
And it's not been as bad as you thought it would be?
No, it's not been as bad as I thought it would be.
Yeah? All right.
That's why I'm saying, come in, join politics.
And I'm sure you'll make a difference for the better.
To many, Sonia Gandhi continues to remain an enigma.
She's not one with more than, say, a handful of close friends. She doesn't appear to have that many interests outside of politics. She doesn't appear to want anything. She's just completely devoted to politics. It's almost as when people who know them will tell you this, that Rajiv was her whole world. When Rajiv disappeared, politics became her world.
She's admired for her hold over the party and is praised for bringing in democratized decision-making in the largely autocratic Congress. However, her adversaries accuse her of perpetuating nepotism in the party. But what remains uncontested is her success in single-handedly reviving a party that many had written off.